Tingles with lullaby. Hello, my tinglings. Today I'm going to show you how I've made these different rolls, this Christmas braid and these orange rolls. There's also lemon rolls here as well. And that's something new I'd never tried before. Also have these plain rolls. So let's go ahead and get started. I'll show you how I've made these. The dough that I've begun with here is just a nice crescent roll mix that I have. I've made it from scratch, but you can start with just crescent rolls, like Pillsbury or whatever you want. You can also use kind of a sweet bread roll as well. This isn't actually the recipe that we used to use when I was a kid. This is something we used to do very commonly on Christmas Eve, which is why I've put this video for today. And yeah, we used to always make them by hand, but the recipe we used was a little bit moister and fluffier than this particular recipe. So if you are making them from your own dough, then what you're first going to want to do is roll it out. So just kind of take in, I mean, you can see the amount of dough that we have here, and you just need to roll it out with a rolling pin. This is the braid that we're starting out with. So for the braid, you want a kind of oval shape. You don't want it to be completely circular. I want it to be a little wider than this, so we're getting it out to a bit of an oval shape. But you don't want it to be completely circular, so you're kind of keeping it elongated a bit as well as we're rolling it out. And I always like to flip it back and forth. This crescent roll mix that I've done here is not super moist, and so I don't need really to flour it as I'm rolling it out. If you have a wetter dough, you may need to flour as you're rolling out as well. But this one doesn't really need to. You can just go like that. So I have a pretty decent shape there. So what we're going to do now is we'll take some butter and going to cut a bit of that off. Just a couple tablespoons. You don't need a ton of butter, but not just like a teaspoon, just usually about a couple tablespoons is about the right amount. So I'll just go ahead and cut that off. And now we'll just melt that. So by the magic of cameras, that's all melted. So what you're going to do is you'll take this and you're not going to put it, cover the entire thing with butter. You're going to start in the middle. We're going to need the sugar as well. So I'm getting the sugar prepared, but you can put the butter down first. So you're just going to cover about the middle third with butter. So you just, it doesn't have to be perfect. It's just kind of getting a bit of butter in there, and it's very imprecise, so just kind of slop it on and move it across. And you don't have to use all your butter. The reason I put more butter in there is I'm going to use that same melted butter for the orange and lemon rolls a little bit later as well. So then you take a little bit of sugar as well, and we're just going to sprinkle that across. Again, this doesn't have to be super precise. It doesn't really matter if it's that even either. Just kinda, you know, that looks good enough. Then we'll grab some cinnamon and sprinkle that across. Again, really easy. Doesn't have to be even. Very imprecise. Perfect. Meaning imperfect, but it doesn't matter. So then what you're going to do is you're going to cut on either side and just kind of cut in strips like this. You want basically an even number of strips on both sides, but I don't count them. I just kind of eyeball it and we see how we go. And so then I've done the other side as well. Basically, my arm ended up covering up everything. Then you're just gonna take one side and then the other. You're just working. One side covers, and you just pull them over to the middle and push them down over each other. They don't really have to be that connected as long as you have this loose kind of over each other, then it'll work. And you see it starts to get this really beautiful pattern as you pull each side over. Just have that beautiful kind of crisscross pattern, nice little braid shape, almost like a fishtail braid, actually. Now, you may notice at some point that it seems a bit uneven, which is what I am noticing about right now. So, I'm going to grab my knife and cut here to even it out so that we have an even number of pieces. So we have 5 and 4, so we need an extra one here. And see here, they get really thin. That doesn't really matter either. You might need to cut it a little bit deeper depending on the type of shape you're going for. But it's very, very forgiving, this. It's not something that requires precision, so that's part of what makes it really good for me. And then you just kind of, at the end, just kind of smoosh it together. And we call that good. Then we'll grab our cookie sheet and some spray. And then just go ahead and spray with some non-stick spray on there. We don't want it to stick. Especially since we're going to put some sticky icing on top. So, best to not make it stick. Then we can just set that to the side as we begin working on our orange and lemon rolls. My ring is a bit annoying there. So, for this part, I use a bit less on this, so about half as much as we did for the braid. So my parts, I kind of have half for the braid, a quarter for the orange rolls and lemon rolls, and then a quarter for the plain rolls. Which, these rolls like this don't actually puff up that much. They're really good for a crescent shape. But anyway, we'll get into the plain rolls later. So, for the orange and lemon rolls, we're going to roll these out in a circular shape. So, the last one was a bit more oblong or oval. In this one, we're going to actually want it to be fairly circular. So, we'll try and even it out. Again, it's not important that it be that precise. Just, you know, it can be kind of wonky. It's very forgiving. Excuse me. It's very forgiving. So, it's not a big deal. Just kind of get it in a rough circle. You want to get it so it's probably, I'm trying to think the best way to describe. I kind of just go by feel, which isn't that helpful. But definitely less than a quarter inch thick as far as rolling it out, but probably not as thin as an eighth an inch thick, so somewhere between that is where you want to roll it out to as far as the thickness goes. Once it gets to that thinness, and there I'm just picking up little pieces that we've left behind. Once it gets to that thickness, then we're going to start prepping our mix or filling, if you want to call it that. So I'm going to do half of these as lemon rolls and half as orange rolls. Orange rolls are something that I've made a lot of time through my life. And this is actually my first time making lemon rolls, so pretty exciting. So you're gonna need to zest the lemon first. So I'm just doing this on a grater, on the smallest side of my grater. If you have a microplane zester, definitely use it, because those things are amazing. I might have to get another one sometime if I'm gonna keep making things with zest in them. But I usually don't use them that much, so I've been making do with my grater. This little grater is actually pretty cool because it has this little slider on the bottom, so it's collecting everything. So we don't have to have a separate plate or anything like that. It all just collects in there. Makes it a little bit harder to clean, but it's pretty good. So for this is gonna give us 8 little crescent rolls. For 8 crescent rolls, I'm using the zest of 1 lemon, just to figure out what our proportions are. Very, very imprecise on. So, when you're making the crescent dough or any kind of baking dough, that part of the chemistry is really precise. But when you get to the things like fillings and that sort of thing, well, this one it's not very precise. Some can be, but this one is not. You can just And I like it to be super zesty. It gives it the best flavor. So I'm trying to get every kind of last bit of zest off of this lemon. Just a little more. Just a little more. There we go. And there we go. We'll just put this into its own little separate bowl. For making the filling on these lemon rolls. Lemon's actually a really lovely flavor. Highly recommend lemon rolls. And I spill. So I'll just put a bit of butter in there, usually about the same amount as the zest. Usually it's about one part zest to one part butter to one part sugar. If anything, maybe a little bit more butter and sugar than zest so that it'll spread nice and evenly. But it's pretty chill. Just do what works. And then we're just going to take that mixture after stirring it and put it onto our half we've cut off, and you're gonna spread this out. You wanna try and get it as close to the edges as you can. So it's gonna end up pretty thin. That's okay, it's just there for a little bit of flavor. It doesn't need to be very thick at all. A lot more of the flavor actually comes from the icing than the actual interior, but it's just really nice to have it on the interior. It just makes it really nice. So you kind of have to work it around a little bit. We probably could have put a little bit more butter in here so that it would spread a little easier. But you're just trying to work it towards those edges and get all of it out there so that you can get it pretty full coverage. So just kind of spread it. Pretty good, just try and use the rest of it up there. And then we're going to cut. So, this I'm going to cut into 8 pieces, first by cutting it in half, and then in quarters, and then each of the quarters in half. And these make little small ones. If you roll it out a bit more or use a bit more dough, they can be a bit bigger. But I actually really like the little cute ones. But if you want a little bit bigger crescent rolls, just roll out a bigger circle and we'll spray this pan as well. We don't want any sticking. And then you just start from the wide end and roll towards the small end. And you get a little crescent shape like that. And just pop it into the pan. So again, just roll from the wide end towards the small end. And that gives you a lovely little crescent shape. And you pop it into the pan. And we'll just repeat that for the rest of these. You can actually, if you get a little bit bigger crescent rolls, you can take those little small side ends and wrap them back on each other, but with the little mini ones, it's a bit too small to do it with. So, on these ones, we're just gonna just let them lay flat, but they're so cute and so snack. So that way we get 8 lemon crescent rolls in there. Can see the beautiful, beautiful crescent there. They're so cute. They're so cute. So yummy. And again, just so you just roll right from the wide end towards the small end, and you want to kind of tuck the point right under so that they don't unroll. So you'll notice all of them, that biggest point is tucked under, and that's the part that's hitting the pan, is the biggest point. So then we'll move on and want to start working on our orange rolls, and it's basically the same process. So we're going to start by zesting the orange. Now, orange rolls, in my family, we've been eating them all my life. Something very Christmassy about orange rolls to me. We always make cinnamon rolls and the cinnamon braids and orange rolls. That is a huge part of Christmas to me. And so that's why I, of course, wanted to share that with you, my lovely tinglings. So I remember when I was a little kid and when my mom first started grating the orange and putting it into the food, I was like, what? Why is she grating the orange? Because obviously, whenever we eat oranges, we would throw away the peels, and so I just thought you couldn't eat the peel at all. And so I just thought it was so weird that we put part of the orange peel into the rolls. But it was so delicious, I was like, well, Mom knows what she's doing, doesn't she? But anyway, with the orange, it's actually a little bit easier since it's round. You can kind of just go around and get every little edge. Whereas with the lemon, it's hard to, you can even see it right over there. The pokey ends still have a lot more zest on them. Whereas on the orange, we're able to get all the zest off a lot easier, though it does take some time, because, well, I don't have a microplane zester. My mom actually got me a microplane zester back when I lived in Utah, but it didn't make the overseas trip, so that's one thing I've missed a few things. One that I missed was my dough whisk, but I've actually gotten a dough whisk now. I'm just gonna reuse this bowl for the lemon, because they're very similar. It's not like having cinnamon in there, where it'll really alter the flavor. So it's the same principle here. We're just gonna put the zest in, and try and get all the zest in there. And then we're just going to, grab some, well, I guess we'll move the rolls over first, and then get our zest ready, if you have a preferred side. So, pop a couple spoonfuls of butter into there, a little bit of extra, 1-to-1, whatever. Seems good. And I have no clean spoon, so I'm just gonna grab some chunks of sugar, but kind of make it so it'll be even, about 1-to-1-to-1 of zest to sugar to butter. But again, the precision on this doesn't really matter. So go ahead and mix that up. Make sure we're pretty happy with the texture, which if it's 1-to-1-to-1 should be very pleasing. And we're just going to spread that across. It's easy to get kind of gloopy little bits all across the way rather than getting one bit right in the middle and then trying to spread that everywhere. So then next we're just gonna try it again. As we did with the lemon, we're just gonna try and spread this all the way out to the edges. So we just want all the edges. Well, we want coverage across everything. You don't want it to only be on the edges. So I got a little bit more butter in the orange, so you can see it spreads just a little bit easier. So I did that one a little better. And then we're just going to do the same thing here again. Just cut into half, and then into quarters, and then into eighths. And so we can see that we're going to have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. And we'll just begin rolling. Again, you just start from the long side, roll to the small side. You do kind of need to pay attention to make sure that it's a bit of a tight roll. So you're going to, you don't want a big hole in the middle of your roll, or else it'll kind of loop out. So you just want to kind of keep it tight, like when you're rolling a sleeping bag. So I'm just going to roll them tight. And then again, most important is make sure that point is face down. So we'll put those down, the point face down, so that they won't unroll as they're baking. So just long side to the point. And then long side to the point. And long side rolling towards the point. And then our last one. Long side. And then we'll just pop those all onto our pan. I would probably usually use a baking sheet for this, but I only have one baking sheet, and that has my braid on it, so that's the reason I'm not using that. Next, we're going to get some of these things out of the way and start rolling out our last piece of dough. This will be our plain rolls. So the crescent rolls, this crescent recipe is really designed for crescent rolls, as you can probably guess by the name. So I can make plain rolls out of it that are not in a crescent shape, but this isn't actually the ideal bread recipe for that sort of thing. It's better to do it with a actual bread recipe, because it just makes them a little tough. These are better when they are rolled up like that. So what I'm going to do here is just take a cup and you use it as a kind of biscuit cutter. So you push it down and then swivel it side to side, really pushing it around, and that'll give you a nice little circle roll. If you have a really fluffy dough, this works really well and makes a really nice biscuit or roll. Whereas these will probably be a little bit flat, but that's okay. So you have a couple different things that you can do after you have got your circle shapes that you can fit. You can just kind of clump everything back together and roll it out again, and then get as many circles as you can again. Or you can start to have a little bit of fun, do something different than just circles. So, like, we could just cut these little bits here. Maybe in these little middle parts. Just kind of push those in, make a fun shape. You can take this, roll that all together into a little ball. Put a little ball in the middle of our roll. There we go. You know, just have some fun. Or let's see, what else could we. Let's roll this up. Maybe make something stringy so we can make a bow. That's not quite gonna be, I think, very stringy. Let's roll it out and kind of turn it into some strips then. So, just gonna roll it so it's a bit flat. You don't want it to be too flat or else it'll cook way quicker than everything else. And then we'll just kind of cut some strips here. And fun thing about dough, all you really need to do is press it together. So you just kind of press it together like that. And that'll go. And then just line that up. And looks like we've got a bit of extra dough there, so we'll cut that off, set that off to the side. And there we go, nice little strip. And we can just treat it like a shoelace. This was the first method I actually learned for tying a shoelace, rather than the method I consider the adult version. And there we go. Have a little bow. Just kind of manipulate it until we're happy with it. And cut off our little extra pieces. And pop those. Might need to adjust things just a little bit to fit everything on. And we can just take everything together, form a nice little ball, And if you want to make something square shaped, you can kind of manipulate it towards that direction and, you know, start shaping towards a more square shape. And we just cut off the sides. And voila, a little square we have. And there we go, quite happy with that. So you're gonna pop those in the oven. My oven is really bad. I think you probably cook them about 12 to 15 minutes, but I can't really say because my oven, I just have to cook things by when they're done. Because it's really bad. So I'm gonna start working here on the icings. This is now the inside of the lemon. We're gonna juice the lemon. And then we'll juice the orange as well for making the icing. So for the icing, you don't actually need a ton of lemon juice. Probably only need half a lemon worth of lemon juice. So put the lemon juice in there, grab our icing sugar or powdered sugar, whatever you want to call it. Soft icing mixture is what Coles calls it. And we'll spoon some in. I probably already got a little too much lemon juice in here. So, because you'd like it to be, this is still quite liquidy. Probably like it to be a little bit thicker than this, but we'll make do. Add a little bit more in, see if we can get it to go thicker. There we go. But I probably overjuiced it just a little bit. We'll try on the next one to see if we can get a more suitable texture for you. It also makes it a little bit harder. You get a little bit more clumps. If it's a little bit thicker, it is a bit easier. Add a little more. See if we can get it to come up more how we want it to. Yeah, I think it just says a little bit too much lemon juice. We'll just roll with it how it is. It's not a huge deal, but you do want, it's easier if it's a little bit of a thicker texture. If we really wanted to, the easiest way would be to spoon some of this out and then just add more without, with taking some of the, you know, the fluid out, but I'm not too worried about it. We'll just go with it how it is. That is yummy though. Delicious lemon flavor. We'll put the extra lemon juice aside. Can use it for something else. Lot of lemon juice. And I'm just gonna spill that everywhere. Well done. So let's start working on our orange icing. The orange icing will juice the orange. Again, we're only gonna really need about half of the orange for juice. So we'll go ahead and juice up that orange. Get a nice fresh orange. This I'm putting in a separate bowl because we're going to make two separate icings. And we'll do a little bit less on that and see how we like the texture and add. Then we can always add more juice in if we want to. So now with a clean spoon, we'll put some more icing mixture in there. Mix that up. Give that a good stir. Just, you know, doesn't need to stay anywhere at all. But that one, you can see it has a little bit more of that orangey color. And we hopefully, it's a little liquidy here, so we'll just add some more. But I think because we started with less juice, we should probably get a nicer texture. Yeah, there we go. It's a pretty good texture there. Just add a little bit more, make it a little bit thicker. Because when the rolls are hot and they come out of the oven, then they'll really help it to soften up and drip down. Yeah, you can see we're getting a little bit more resistance from the icing now. That's just about perfect. Just make it nice and smooth. Yeah, happy with that. Yummy. And this is, yeah, definitely a little liquidy. Oh well, we got our rolls out of the oven, ready to, those are the lemon and the orange. So yummy. So you want to cook them until they're about that golden color on top. So again, you want to remember if you are making orange and lemon, which is orange and which is lemon, so you get the icing. Just gonna take a little spoonful, kind of put it across the top. You don't really have to make sure everything's covered because it will start to drip down because they are warm because you've just taken them out of the oven. And so it'll help them, as long as you've just got a fair amount of icing across the top there, it should drip down and you get a really good coverage on that. So, depending on how much icing you have, depends on maybe how much you want to put on. You can see I'm starting with just about a half of a little scoop on a teaspoon. If you have a little bit more icing, you can do more, but I like to try and be precise with my icing, so I use and that looks just about right. So then you can just take the little extra bits at the end and spread them between the extras. But you can see if you look at the ones that we started with, they've already started kind of melting and are down onto the pan, which means that they're getting more coverage. You'll see this one is a little bit more finicky. But it's the same process. Just gonna cover those all. So next we'll do the icing for our cinnamon braid. This one's just milk and icing sugar, but I've already mixed it up. But you can see that has a really nice texture. That is a perfect texture. Just kind of slowly falls off the spoon. It's delightful. And so with that done, ready to put the icing sugar away. And we'll put that away. And I'm gonna need to, because I've put the plain rolls in with the braid, gonna take those off because I don't want icing on those. I did end up putting a little donut on the top of that one. Just a bit of fun. And this pan is quite hot, so don't follow my example and don't burn yourself. You should use a spatula or a flipper. But I am, So we'll set those to the side, and then we'll bring the braid right over here. And then grab our icing, and it's basically the same idea. I just want to protect my counter here. It's basically the same concept as with the orange and the lemon rolls, where you just want to kind of spread it out across the middle, and it should kind of drip on its own. You can start to see it dripping off the edges. Most important is just right there in the middle, and the rest will kind of, it won't get complete coverage, but that's okay. But this is really nice, adds a bit of sweetness and just a nice icing, really light little layer on the top of your braid. So what you can actually wrap a piece of cardboard with foil, and then if you let this dry, the icing dry, you can transfer this over to that and cover it in plastic. And this is a great gift to give neighbors or friends, something like that. Again, this is what we used to do on Christmas Eve, is prepare a nice Christmas braid. And they're so lovely and beautiful and just really yummy. So that is how you make a Christmas braid and the associated rolls. Look at that beautiful braid. Partially eaten. Up, look at it. Oh, yeah. Look at that beautiful little tray of goodies. Perfect for giving to someone or for eating yourself. And a nice little Christmas, my dinklings. Thanks for watching.